Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to integrate other Syncfusion Angular components into the Angular tab component using the Angular and G template option. In this example, you will see different components like chart, calendar, and dropdown are integrated as individual tab items. I will show you the code snippet to achieve this. I open an Angular application where I have already added the Angular tab component with a few basic properties. I have imported the tab module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Navigations package. If you would like to know how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular tab component to it, click the video link in the card above. Now, I run this example using the command ng-serve. Looking at the output page now, the tab component rendered with the three headers, HTML, Java, and Python. If I want to place the Angular UI components instead of these tab contents, then I need to use Angular and G template option. Now, I plan to add Angular chart, calendar, and dropdown list components to the tab component, so primarily I need to install these component packages in the application. Let me show you the steps to add chart components as first tab item in the tab component. First, let me install the chart component using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularcharts --save. I am skipping this step here as I have already installed this package. Navigate to the app module file and import the chart all module from the Syncfusion Angular charts package and register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Here, I am going to display a chart component in the first tab item, therefore, let me remove the header and content properties from tab item and define ng template tags with the template reference variables. Then, I need to add a header to the tab item inside the division element. Next, to add the content for the tab item, I define the chart component and add the chart series type as line inside the eSeries definition. For this chart component, I plan to add categorical data source, therefore, I create a chart data object and assign array of objects with two fields, namely month and sales value. Then, I assign this object to the data source property and map the data source fields, month to the X name property and sales value to the Y name property of the series. As I am using categorized data for the x-axis, so I define the variable x-axis settings with the category value type. Now, I assign this variable to the primary x-axis property. In the output page now, first tab pane is displayed with the chart component, and the other two tab items have string contents. Next, I will place calendar and dropdown list as tab items, so I will explain the steps to be followed. As I said before, I am going to show calendar and dropdown list components as tab items, so Syncfusion Angular calendars and dropdowns packages need to be installed. I am skipping this step here, as I have already installed these packages in the application. Now, navigate to the app module file and import calendar and dropdown list modules from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular calendars and dropdowns packages and register those modules within the imports array of the ng module section. Next, I remove header and content properties from the tab item tags and define ng template tags with appropriate headers inside the division element. Then, define calendar and dropdown list components within this content section. For the dropdown list, I need to populate the data source, so let me pass an array of strings to the sports data variable. Now, I assign this variable to the data source property and define the placeholder property with appropriate value to display it as a placeholder text. Along with this, I need to import CSS for these components in the style file. Looking at the output page now, the tab component displays three tab items with headers and the content. If I switch to the tab header one by one, I can view the calendar and dropdown list components rendered. In this video, I have shown you how to integrate Angular UI components as a tabs pane inside the tab component. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.